Cincinnati had three race riots between 1829 and 1845, in which half of the black population each time by violence were driven out of the city. Baltimore had in 1859, and replicated in St. Louis, Missouri as well, attempted to get rid of all free blacks in their midst just before the Civil War by legislative
action. The good news is that there has been a movement across political ideology to do something about the numbers of people that we have locked up across
the classroom and is compelling the reading list you put together for your students.
You don't cut through the othering unless people actually find a way to sit down and have conversations with people that they may think are different. It's one of the most powerful things that we can do is talk to people who we think are different and see the humanity that we all share. I would encourage you to find a way to get folks into your classrooms. If your class is not diverse enough by virtue of life experience, socioeconomic status, race, find a way to get folks into the from the community into your class. Or better yet, go out into the community and get your students exposed to people who they think are different, so that they can see that they're not. That we're talking about people who are somebody's son or daughter, mother or father, and that what we have in common is so much more than what is different.